Welcome to Learn at Home program. Today we shall be looking at the topic procedure and conditions for marriage. My name is Golar Titus Gofon, a teacher with the junior secondary school section. This topic covers JS 1 to 3. We have looked at the issue of marriage in our last lesson, and we define marriage as a legal union between a man and a woman who comes together as husband and wife. We also looked at the types of marriage, and then we considered the importance or the significance of marriage. Today we are going to look at procedure and conditions of marriage. When you are thinking of going into marriage, we've made it very clear in our last lesson that marriage is not for boys and girls, but it is for the mature. So when there is a willingness to get married, then one has to be prepared. You have to be prepared. If you are not prepared to go into marriage, then you are not supposed to venture into it, and it is for the mature. And the procedure for marriage, proposal, the first is that in Nigerian society or communities, most communities in Nigeria, it is the man that goes to look for the wife. Therefore, the man proposes to a young lady whom he feels they are going to stay together as husband and wife. So it is very important for the man to first of all make a proposal. After the proposal, the lady has to accept. And if the lady accepts the proposal, they now get the parental consent. The two families have to accept that, yes, these two are ready to live together as husband and wife. Then after that, there will be courtship. Courtship is a period whereby the two had to sit together. They sit together and then learn how to know each other. They try to experience some certain things about each other and then get to know each other better. And they discuss issues of, oh, when we get married, how many children are we going to have? What are the things that you like? What are the things that you dislike? And when they are able to understand each other, then you discover that they are good to go. Then there is also payment of bride price, which is obtainable in almost all the communities in Nigeria. You have to pay the bride price, and after that, the marriage ceremony proper takes place. This involves getting together all the families involved. You bring friends together, and then the marriage contract, you know, is done. Now, what are the conditions of, for marriage? There are certain conditions that needs to be followed. Number one condition is physiological fitness. Physiological fitness. Number two is psychological fitness. Psychological fitness. Number three is compatibility. Compatibility. And then social stability. One important condition is financial readiness. Financial readiness, and then sometimes counseling is very, very important. Now let's talk about physiological fitness. When we talked about physiological fitness, I have earlier on made a very clear position that marriage is mainly for the matured. You have to be physically strong. The man should be able to get, to work, do some certain things in order to provide for the house. And then for the lady, you have to be matured. In a situation where the lady gets pregnant, she should be able to give birth at the point of maturity of pregnancy. So it is very important that, as it's been encouraged, young people should not get married less than 18 years. You have to be 18 years and above so that you'll be able to carry on all the physical activities that involved marriage. Now, next one is the psychological fitness. Psychological fitness has to do with tolerance, it has to do with patience, it has to do with wisdom. If you are not ready to tolerate each other, it will be difficult for that marriage to stand. And then you have to be patient with each other. So as you are getting married, the issue of wisdom also is very key to sustenance of a marriage. The high level of self-control is needed. You know, sometimes a little things, we are so emotional, our feelings, you know, we are carried away by our feelings and emotions, and then you see crisis begins to occur. When that happens, you know that such person is not ready and not fully prepared for marriage. Compatibility. Compatibility is all about interpersonal relationship. When we talk of interpersonal relationship, we are talking about having same interests, same opinions, understanding each other. You know, when you know the right person, then you will be able to live well. Another issue that is very important in the issue compatibility, especially in this 21st century time, is the issue of genotype. I would like to say this here because we have seen so many families that have suffered because they've not really taken the rule or obey, you know, what is expected. And we have the issue of genotype. If you are AA and AS, and then you have SS. Then when an AS and AS gets married to each other, there's the possibility of them having all their children with sickle cell disease. And that's why we are always advising that when you get to the point of getting married, make sure you go to the hospital and do a test and ensure that AS and AS should not come together as husband and wife. AA and AA, excellent. AA and AS, yes, very good. So please, let's take note of that. The other one is social stability. You should be able to discuss together. The issue of communication is what is breaking homes, you know, these days. When husband and wife cannot discuss about issues that concerns their families, then there's the possibility of that marriage breaking off. So there should be effective communication. If you have a problem with your husband or with your wife, you should be able to discuss. Discuss in your room, discuss about the progress of the family, and that will bring about peace and understanding in the family. Financial readiness. So many young people are always rushing into marriage. And when you rush into marriage and you don't have anything tangible doing, it becomes a problem because marriage has responsibilities and rules. If you cannot provide food, you cannot provide housing, you cannot provide the basic needs of the family, you are bound to have problems. So it is good the couples must have some job that brings an income. No matter how small, get something and you pool your resources together for the upkeep of the family. Yes, in most of our organizations today, among the Muslims, among the Christians, there's counseling. Premarital counseling is very important, where the two comes together and they educate them on how they will be able to understand with each other. I have seen families that got separated because of the use of a toothpaste, because the other one is saying, why do you just press it anyhow? And then the other one will say, press it from down and make it clean. And that became a problem, and separation came as a result of use of toothpaste. In fact, I have also seen a family that got separated because of the use of light. One would want to sleep with light, another wouldn't want to sleep with light. So when they came together, it was a serious problem that at the end of the day, it led to problems. So to separation and divorce. So please let us take note of all that. Can you think of some of the effects of lack of readiness? I am asking this question, begin to think. What do you think are some of the effects of lack of readiness on marriage? If you are not ready for marriage, what do you think? Now, I have these points here. It will lead to extramarital sexual relationship. If you are not prepared for marriage, by the time you get into it and you don't really love each other, you see the person going out, which is not good for the family. And the second, depression will set in. When depression sets in, there are a lot of thoughts that comes, and sometimes it may lead to divorce or separation. And fighting, the house or the two families, the couples will keep fighting every time because they were not prepared. Inadequate finance. Maybe you married the person and he was having good money. Now that the money is not there, problems will start coming up, and divorce and separation. So it is good for us to understand that when we make right choice concerning marriage, then we will be able to live well and then enjoy our marital lives. In conclusion, it should be understood that marriage is an institution that one should not rush into. You have to think about it so that you will make the right choice. And when you make the right choice, you'll be able to live a life that is that the society, you know, is happy with, and then there will be development and progress. As we looked at this topic, you should be able to take maybe a paper or your exercise book and answer these questions. You can explain readiness in marriage. Just take your time to explain what it means. List the 6 procedures to follow before getting married. And then state 5 conditions for marriage as discussed and write brief notes on each of them. Then the last question is, what are the effects of lack of readiness on marriage? With this, I would like to give you this home tax. Please make sure you work on this home tax and the evaluation given on the topic. In our next lesson, we will look at those questions accordingly. Now, describe briefly the procedures and conditions for getting married in your community. Thank you very much for listening. Stay safe and see you next time. Thank you.